Don't be like Daenerys and ignore the bell. Hit it, Dragaris.
What's up, guys? Welcome to the last Game of Thrones podcast, because it's the last Game of Thrones episode. We just watched the finale.
It's over. 8 years. 8 years of fandom, 8 years of emotional investment, 8 years of wondering what the hell is going to happen, reading every Reddit theory, reading everything, reading whatever material we could, and this is what it has led to. And
this episode, for this whole season, basically, especially this episode, it's like idli without sambar. Or
right.
Chutney.
It's
just bland.
It's just idli.
It's just the idli. It's
which
just bland.
Which is bad. And like, yeah, it's just...
Yeah, I mean, I don't. Do you like idli without sambar?
I don't know. No.
There are so many moments in this. Obviously, before you guys go ahead, if you haven't seen the finale, please stop right now. Go watch the finale.
Only spoilers in this
video.
But
basically, hug diya in log ne. Like, big time hug diya hai. Ekdam
I'm just...
Goat tatti kar diya hai in log ne.
Aur ye log ne itna lack of... you know, they've lost interest, and we can figure it out, because even in this remember, two episode pehle there was a Starbucks kept at Daenerys ka table. This episode had a water bottle dragon pit wale scene mein, where they whoever remaining people in Westeros are sitting. There's a bottle of plastic water right there.
I think,
are they trying to show Westeros modern hair in some way or the other? Like, what is the hidden meaning behind this?
I think Cersei and Jaime had the right idea. They're like, let's just die together. Because
jiyenge saath jiyenge marenge. I can't believe they got a more poetic death than what happened in this episode.
Drogon had it right. Like, Drogon, it takes his... I had a little thought that Drogon is up there in some mountain in Essos. And he's using Dany like a doll. And he's like, he's doing chai with her.
That's very good. Norman Bates' ka dragon version hai.
Yeah,
Mara Drogon.
I was thinking more like
Psycho Killer.
Weekend at Bernie's type.
Okay,
you know,
sure.
He props her up. And he,
that's sweet.
If you haven't seen Weekend at Bernie's, basically...
Oh, if you haven't seen Psycho also. So many spoilers. Yeah. Well, sorry, guys.
Full of spoilers. So the whole episode was just so boring.
Let's start with the start.
So the first 10-15 minutes are just people walking.
Like Hunger Games ka starting.
Yeah.
Dystopian society. Daenerys aa gayi hai. Sabko aag laga de baby fire karke. And people are dead. And Tyrion is like, I have made
amazing.
A huge mistake. It looked great.
It looked all like grey.
It looked very, very
doom
nice.
And gloom.
I liked like the first 10 minutes. We all thought our audio kharab hai because there was absolutely no background score, no dialogue. So we were just like, kya? Okay, subtitles bhi nahi aa rahe. Kya ho raha hai yahan pe? But it was quiet.
Yeah.
The
and,
devastation.
You know, it's funny. I was just thinking, it's so funny that there's this one scene. Well, we'll get to it, but as we go forward, there's this one scene where they're trying to figure out how to make a peaceful ending. Davos suggests that, hey, Unsullied, why don't you guys take this land?
Right.
And become lords.
Right.
And I was thinking, you know, my head was like, yeah, Unsullied can't reproduce, so fayda kya hai?
Kya karenge?
But then I was like, yeah, wait a minute, they kind of can. Because pehle to sab mar gaye the in the Night's King.
Right.
Now, and this...
They've come suddenly. There are so many.
Thousands of Unsullied have showed up. So, I was like, clearly they can reproduce.
Very quickly, they can produce grown men into their...
The shot of this episode was definitely Daenerys walking with the wings of the dragon.
The Drogon behind. Yeah. That was a beautiful shot. That was gorgeous. But yeah, I honestly liked the first 10-15 minutes of the episode where we see her as her queen make her big speech, you know, which she used to do in the previous season also back in Meereen. And it was good. It was nice. Emilia Clarke has killed it. Like, there's been such a big disservice to her character, but she has done such a good job with whatever she's got, whatever material she's got. It's great. And you can see Tyrion and Jon ki
pat rahi hai wahan pe. It's like that Champions Trophy mein, Hardik Pandya scored, it was hitting sixes and all.
Right.
It doesn't make any difference because we lost.
Eventually, it makes no difference.
The cinematographer was really good.
The acting was really good.
The thing is, the foundation of it is all what's on the paper. And what's on paper is tatti.
It's trash.
Yeah, ye log ne basically, tatti kya hai paper pe, fir waiver mein bolye log script, you know.
It's true. And like you know, like I said, you can see the carelessness in the writing, it's very bad.
The Daenerys death scene was so poorly constructed.
Yes. Spoiler alert, she dead.
Of course. Yeah. I mean, have you seen the episode?
I mean, not that you expect anything else.
And like it is so anticlimactic, and I mean there's nothing wrong with being anti, but he's like, and you're my queen. You'll always be my queen. Chunk. You know, and then suddenly she bleeds from her mouth.
Yeah.
And she's dead.
She's dead. And Joffrey bled like
and like what is, what is
because of poison but
this like what is going on, like Grey Worm has seen Jon Snow act like call his troops back what is going on, like is she,
she had no prediction.
I think in the end she's delusional. There's got to be a total it's actually interesting, like, you know, because I don't think he really has any intent of killing her till she says that they have the people
that they,
against
they'll
her
have
choice.
No choice. I think he was still in double minds. I mean, before this he had a conversation with Tyrion where Tyrion tells him that this is the right thing to do, or of course Jon ko to karna hi hai right thing, wo to bechara jee nahi payega varna. So I think yes, the intent is there to like maybe have a word with her, maybe reason with her. He's giving her a lot of chances, you can see that, and again both of them have done a great job. And when she says that people who don't choose what is our right.
The Jon Snow Daenerys love track is so boring.
It's very boring.
They're
the most boring characters anyway. I've always maintained this. I've always thought about this. And getting them together has been whatever.
Yeah. So
such
so
a waste, man. Such a waste. This whole so many years that, of love.
Then the dragon shows up and dragon is like, "Acha, mar gayi."
Yeah.
Now dragon is thinking, "Acha, oh." So dragon has two thoughts. Okay, like okay.
Should I eat her? Or should I?
No, yeah. He's looking at her. She's dead. He's obviously paying. And then he just blows up the Iron Throne.
Yeah. Yeah.
And what is the... There's no logic here except for...
It's
the symbolism.
One thing she... Yeah.
It's just symbolism
course,
to show
that,
the audience that the throne doesn't mean shit.
Yeah.
But why are you using the dragon to do it? The dragon is just a dragon.
It made a good scene. Till Daenerys' death and whatever, what he does with the body, I liked it. I thought it was a beautiful scene. And Jon is also like...
The whole thing was shot. Even after the aftermath...
Yeah.
It
was shot beautifully.
And like, it just makes so no sense. Like, then they come, had this little council, and then this is one scene.
Yeah.
My God.
Oh, God, yeah. So.
When Tyrion is like, you know what? Nothing was better than heroes and better than kings. Stories.
Yeah.
And at that point, I was like, yeah, stories. The one you just ruined.
One thing you could have focused on, stories,
you know,
which you didn't.
But I have to say, though, this is all going to work out in George R.R. Martin's favor.
Yeah.
Because now...
Because the stories will matter then, because people read the books after this.
Exactly. So when the book comes out, it's going to be the number one bestseller.
Immediately. Of course. There was any doubt about that.
No,
but,
because other ones haven't been number one.
They haven't?
No.
Wow.
Game of Thrones, the first book, Game of Thrones and the Song of Fire and Ice, didn't even register on the bestseller.
Wow.
The second book was like in the top 10 or so, top 10, 15.
Okay.
The third book came in the top
10. Then, acha. Gradual process.
Yeah, so
ye ulta ja raha hai basically. The show started off with a bang and tapered down as the seasons were going, and the books didn't start off as well, and I think by the end of it, it would be the best.
So, Arya became a faceless man. And,
Arya became and Christopher Columbus, Abu Jaigi West.
Pehle she became a faceless man.
Yeah.
And only point of that, from a story point of view, is to remove the phrase. That's the remove the house. World of Frey's and that was the only reason she used it.
She killed,
That's it.
Her appearance is, definitely.
Okay.
The whole
And she used her sneaky, you don't know where I am.
Yeah.
To sneak up on Jon to tell him, hey, you need to kill.
Yeah, and the Night King, which was fair.
Okay, and Bran can...
Bran,
he can do this,
he can do so many things, but Bran is now the king.
But then Bran is like, why do you think I've come so far? I wanted to...
He's cracking jokes, this stoner child, and just like...
Where did he come stoner for you?
And he just looks like a stoner kid.
No, that's because he's stoic.
Yeah.
That's not stoner,
He just looks, I'm so over it, and then he does his eyes and all.
No, that's
like,
Sansa.
Sansa's the Regina George of Westeros. She's like, I want independence. I'm not going to be with it. It's fun. Sansa's still fun. She has some masala. Baki all are so... And okay, honestly, now that we're talking about Sansa, that scene where that Tully guy comes to say, okay, main king ban sakta, and she's like, just bed jao, please. Aapki koi aukaat nahi hai. Please bed jaiye. That was a funny scene. I think that was good.
What is the point of funny scenes?
But, see, I'm just trying to take out the positives from whatever we got. Because I'm a nicer person than you are.
Ghanta. Listen.
And because it's an 8-year investment, I need to see the good things. That is the only way I can make myself happy, because this show has been very, very important to me in a lot of ways. And just seeing such a disappointing end, I want to remove the positives and like just be like, achhe memories to the. It's like a bad relationship. It's like a relationship. It starts well and then starts ending, and like everything goes haywire, and it's just like, okay, their memories.
Grey Worm's like, he wants justice, okay?
Yaade,
and so they're like, okay, so...
Bhool jaati hai, sorry. Yaade, yaad aati hai. Please continue. No, I'm done.
I don't know what the hell you're saying.
I was singing Yaade Yaad Aati Hai Memories. I was just making a song to...
Achha, toh Game of Thrones ki baat kar rahe hai
koi? Chaliye, chalo. Yes, Grey Worm.
So, so there's so many logic fails. He's like, okay, so they want to kill Tyrion. They don't kill Tyrion. He becomes the Hand.
Yeah, they want to kill Jon.
Like, no, we'll send him to the... We'll send him to the
dude, that was just... I'm like, yeah.
Why would he agree to that? He's like, okay, cool. I trust you guys. All right.
Bye.
Meanwhile, I'm going to get on a boat and go to the Isle of Nath. And I'm gonna not give a shit about the result and, of the whatever's gonna happen.
Oh god, yeah.
And apparently all those thousands of Ansarid fit out on one boat.
Yeah, they're all off to the beaches.
And the Dothraki are just like, okay, chalo wapas.
Yeah, what here. Happened to the Dothraki? They were there in the start when Daenerys is making her speech that breaking wheels, hum sab tod denge, hum ye kar denge, wo kar denge. And they're there after that.
They
even in the long night, they go. We all thought the Dothrakis are dead because of the fire thing. And then they return, of course. And then they return again when Daenerys made her speech. And then they're gone again. So, like, imagine they've left that continent and they've come here. And now Daenerys is dead. And they're like, hey, what is going on with them?
I'm telling you, Drogon had the best idea. He's take the chick and let's just go.
Yeah.
And just forget about it.
Yeah.
And like this, the end is so contrived, man. It's like this fan servicing. It's like mimicking Lord of the Rings to a T. Like at the end, the last scene where again, all full circle.
Yeah.
He has become the Hand.
He's been a sucker for full circle this season.
Yeah, Tyrion has become a Hand.
Yeah, and he has a small.
Bronn is Lord of High Garden. Bronn,
for some reason, is High Garden. To chalo, he was promised, but he's the master of coin. When he's not shown even one quality of being anything like good with money, he just spends it. Then and he's talking about building brothels before.
Bronn
like,
should be Bronn. And that's the conversation they're doing. Yeah. Brothels before ships.
Yeah.
Bronn should have been the master of war.
Yeah.
If anything, he should be. He's
He's got the most tactical.
So Devos becomes ships. Of course, the guy who didn't finish complete the citadel.
Yeah.
Sam
is the grandmaster. Song of Ice and Fire. Woi, George R. R.
Martin. Oh my God. That scene where he opens the book and he's like, and the entire tale has been told, the Song of Ice and Fire. I was like,
it was quite cringy.
And then Jon goes to the north and there's Tormund is still chilling there.
I like that Brienne wrote Jaime's incomplete story in the night book, and then she sat and wrote three pages of what he's done.
Why didn't she just write like, hey, Jaime's a little fuckboy.
Yeah, number one.
Hate it and quit it.
Yeah, Jaime, hate you. There were very funny memes also about Brienne writing and what she would be writing in the diary that Jaime, about Jaime.
Ye sab Reddit pe hoga.
Haan, sab Reddit, Twitter, sab jagah, bahut sare memes hain. Dekh lije, kaafi funny hai. But it was a nice scene, I think.
You know,
and I have a soft spot for Jaime. So
when you write with that kind of ink, first thing you have to do is let the ink sit. Right?
Yeah, number one. But she slammed it. So yeah, you're like, oops, Jaime.
Yeah, I think it's a great metaphor
for the entire season. For the season.
How carefully it's been constructed.
Yeah.
I was watching that. I was like, yeah, the ink. Any kid who has used the ink pen.
Yes, calligraphy ka first rule.
Are all of us in
fountain pen. Yeah.
Fourth standard are using the ink pen. Yeah, we all know. And I write like this anyway.
Same. I write like this.
Ulta.
I'm lefty.
So anyway, I know there's blue ink all over my hand when I'm done. It doesn't dry that quickly.
But technicality ko kyon baat kar raha hai? The plastic bottles kept in
medieval times. One mentioned to Robert of the veil wala bachcha.
Oh yeah,
mummy ke tit pe choose ke bada ho gaya.
Yeah it was quite funny to see him
Harry Potter. Who's that kid in Harry Potter?
Neville Longbottom. He long bottomed. He looks good, I guess. Yes, for a child.
I have good memories about him.
Oh god. Oh no. But yeah, it was fun to see. I think the Lords of Riverrun and this and
Of course they have to. The jokes of for me, I was getting time irritated with the jokes because I was like, such an unsavory end.
Yeah.
It's like you're trying to serve people dessert, but main course khatam nahi hua hai.
Yeah.
You know, I'm like, arre khane to do, bhai. You know, and they're like, what's next? Let's have
vanilla ice cream.
When Sam suggests,
good dessert, just vanilla ice cream.
When Sam suggests, let's have democracy.
Yeah.
And like, oh, I let my horse vote. my dog can vote too. So the lords are not interested in a democrat. At least it's semi-democratic now.
At least. But yes, okay, making Bran the king of the Iron Throne.
Sansa's like, you know, from now on, the North will be independent.
And
Yara's like, say what now? And the Prince of Dawn, who's sitting basically.
He's doing nothing. Yeah, he's just like. Egg line, chilling.
He had to say I once.
Yeah,
yeah.
Even Robin, the grow up child, yeah, he was looking at everyone, he's like, okay, I.
This is. But. Watching this whole episode.
Yeah.
I was just. I didn't.
Anticlimactic.
Nee, that is the 100%.
Yeah.
This whole season anticlimactic.
True.
I think you just go back and just re. Maybe can they can take all the footage and just recut it.
There is not a petition.
To recut it.
No, to rewrite to. Please don't do that. That is ridiculous.
No, no one's going to do anything.
Yeah, I mean, it's just funny that people are going on change.org and writing a petition.
It's just a slap in the face of the writers that there are a million people out there who are disappointed with it.
With what has been done.
I mean, there are videos going around on YouTube about how the cast is disappointed.
Yeah, I just read Emilia Clarke's exit interview on Entertainment Weekly, and you can just see how much she's trying to. You know, just defend. And she said her feelings, and she was not okay with the turn Daenerys took. She said as clearly as she could. And you can see, I mean, it's sad, man. It's just really sad.
What's interesting is these actors, they are outside, after George R. R. Martin, they are the ones who know the characters the best.
Exactly. Of course, they've lived it for so many years.
So when they themselves don't see the trajectory, then there's a problem.
That's
there.
That's a big telling, right?
It may be that all these ideas, all the end games, whatever happens at the end, are George R. R. Martin ideas.
Yeah, they are plot points. Yeah.
Sansa becoming Queen of the North.
Daenerys becomes the Mad Queen.
Dora the Explorer.
Yeah.
John going back and becoming. So John was the 998
Lord Commander of the Night's Watch.
Ed became the 999.
And then
John becomes
1,000.
So it all works out that way, right?
And
again, suddenly he opens the door and it's almost like an homage to the opening scene, you know, where opening scene of Game of Thrones, episode 1, season 1.
Yeah.
You have Vema Royce from House Royce coming in and getting killed by the White Walker.
Yeah.
And they show you the
game. And that
opening.
Is the end,
That's exactly how they close the show. But I don't think there's a single person out there, and if you are someone who out there, then you're probably just a fair weather fan who just likes it for. We never watched Game of Thrones for a fairy tale ending, that's pretty now. But we never watched Game of Thrones because it's all going to be like lovey dovey and everyone's going to shake hands and give each other kisses and be like, that's the end.
Yeah.
And that's what they did. They made it into a now you can. This last episode was as good as a fairy tale ending that you could possibly get. All our favorite characters are sitting around tables and joking about hookers and brothels.
Yeah,
and,
true. It like that looked like a sitcom. Though I wouldn't mind seeing a spin-off series of the small council doing everyday work, government jobs. But
it doesn't matter. I mean, I know. I was thinking about Arya. I was like, no one in the history, thousands and thousands of 5,000 years of history, no one's gone west.
No.
No one's got on a boat and said, you know what? Let me see what's on this side.
I'm on a boat.
That just sounds unbelievable that no one's tried to go west.
Why? She'll discover new countries.
And I think
for spices.
The epitome of this episode find was India. when Bran tells the small council that he'll go find Drogon.
I think that was a joke.
And the next thing they do is nothing. No, they meant it as a joke. They were making, we are the joke here.
We are the joke. Hamara mazak uraya ja raha hai.
They're making you believe, you as the audience believe, arey, Bran kuch karne wala hai. And kya karta hai?
Kuch nahi karta.
Aur is baar we realize that Bran ka khada bhi nahi hota hai.
Yes.
And what uska naam, why is it Bran
the broken? Because he has broken legs.
No, it should be Bran the boring. Itta sala boring aadmi hai wo. All these powers kuch nahi karta hai. Kursi pe baith ke.
But like, you know, usko Bran the broken bulaya ja raha tha. I was like, kafi annoying naam hai for like, if I'm being called the king, I don't want to be called Shreemi the stupid. Like that, just don't call me that, man.
Let's change Shreemi the stupid. Chalo.
No, let's not. There's already Creamy. There's Shreemi the stupid. Let's just not do this.
No, you gave yourself that.
I did not give myself that.
Literally 10 seconds ago, you just said that.
I was using an example that Bran the broken is dumb. You shouldn't call him that. And I'm glad Tyrion lived, I guess. I thought he was going to die. I was pretty sure he was going to die.
Of course Tyrion is going to live.
I thought he
was. Of course Arya's going to live. Of course Jon is going to pet the wolf. Because
that was very sweet.
Yeah,
for
because
people like me.
This last episode was written by the cast and crew of like, of this Disney and the Seven Princes. Like, what do you know? Sleeping Beauty. Or Cinderella. This last episode was written by the writers of Cinderella.
Yes. And the fun part is that most of the Disney fairy tales also have very dark origins, which had been PG.
Literally the only person who died in this episode was one unnamed Lannister soldier.
And Daenerys.
Daenerys
mar gayi. Kafi bad rehta. But exactly, it was so bad. It was so badly done. We all knew she's gonna die. It was like just.
We watched it in the office. Now I'm gonna go home and my family's gonna watch it.
Yeah.
And I'm gonna sit and watch it with them again. Yeah. I'm gonna get so frustrated. And maybe I'll do another video, like maybe just on my Instagram or something about my frustrations about the whole. And why I think we as fans should feel frustrated.
Yeah.
But again, going back, it's all gonna work out in George R. R. Martin's favor.
Yeah.
Because there's a new Game of Thrones prequel that will come out in 2020.
Yeah.
There's two more that are being written.
There are lots of shows being written in the prequel series.
So you'll have lots of Game of Thrones stories. And his when the next he hasn't even begun the seventh book.
He has.
No.
He hasn't.
No. He's only been working on the same sixth book for the last 8 years.
Oh, huh? How many parts are to come out?
7.
Oh.
And I mean, if for
those, I thought this is the final book.
The last thing that's happened in the book is that Jon Snow got stabbed by his
right.
own.
Right. Yeah, and Daenerys people. Gets diarrhea. I know that. She's, yeah, that was the last bit about her character in that one.
I mean,
that's still better than death, so I guess, but.
Is it?
Yeah.
I mean, have you had diarrhea? I think this show has been diarrhea for the most part.
Yeah.
It's been a combination of loose motion and diarrhea. You know, that's what I mean by saying it's tutty. It's great. I think that the season exists because it's confirmed that Breaking Bad is the best written TV show of all time. It is.
Sure.
It has a great ending. This is just bullshit, man.
I will still be a little nicer to the show because it's given me 5 amazing seasons. And I, like I said, nothing
what?
Has evoked this kind of emotion
we
in me.
We spent 2 seasons with the High Sparrow. We spent
Post season 4 or 5, I think, it went all downhill. 2 seasons were given to High Sparrow's character development and not even 2 episodes for Daenerys' madness. That is ridiculous. That is downright ridiculous.
No. So you know the moment when Cersei blows up the...
The Scepter Baylor.
The Scepter Baylor and kills all those people.
Mm.
That it took 20 episodes for that process to happen.
For that to happen. And so when for Cersei, a evil person to take that step.
Correct.
Yeah.
So when you go through that entire process at the end, it seems earned.
Yeah.
And it seems
of course.
Worth
that
it.
Is, I think, one of the most beautiful scenes of this show.
Yeah.
And the music.
And that's why none of the transition to madness doesn't seem earned.
Yeah.
The beating of the Night King here doesn't seem earned.
Not at all.
In fact, the Night King was such a disappointing episode because there was no attempt to beat the Night King.
Mm.
And it seemed like Arya randomly got
just
lucky.
Just popped up, yeah.
Which is insane. Even this episode, the ending, Jon goes back into takes the wildlings back north of the wall, and you see a little plant growing.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's just so
vegetation.
Oh.
But yeah, bichara Jon, he just be like, "Kya? Yeah, Tyrion bhi treason kiya, usko hand of king bana diya, mere ko bol diya, jao yahan se, ladki nahi milegi." But okay, fine. Jon and women don't really get together properly. Anyway.
Did Brienne even have a word to say in this?
No. She did. She said that ships are more important than brothels. She made the correct point in the small council meeting.
Yeah, she looks pretty badass in her.
Yeah, she did. She did. I'm happy. Brienne's character development has been great.
Brienne started that, right? She was the Kingsguard to King
Renly.
Renly.
Yeah. Renly Baratheon.
Renly Baratheon.
Yes.
Now she's a legit Kingsguard.
Yeah, and she's a knight. So yeah, it's a very it was disappointing.
Brandon doesn't want to be Lord of Winterfell, but he's okay being King of the 6 Kingdoms.
Yeah. I don't know, man.
I mean,
I don't even know.
Oh, and this Dawnish plotline. What happened to that woman?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Cersei had captured that woman.
I have a feeling she died. Cersei, Jaime, wo uska body nahi dikha, wo bhi wahi thi kahi. But yeah, it's been a disappointing end to a show which started off very, very, very
at
well.
At least, like, maybe Jon should have climbed on Drogon and gone into the sunset. And
maybe, just, yeah. Maybe like, that would, you know, still be more like, haan, okay, chal.
Like,
makes sense.
Like, heartbroken that he's killed his...
Yeah, his lover.
But I mean, the Jon track, again, let's go back
very,
to the
very, very anticlimactic. Why was he Targaryen? Mm-hmm. What was this whole,
it's been left alone because they don't know what to do with it. But in the books, no way he's going to leave that alone. I mean, I know, just think of it, like all the circles that he's creating, George
exactly.
Martin's creating.
Exactly, yeah. For him, for Jon, too.
No, like Ned Stark's children.
Yes.
You know, like he gets slayed.
Yeah.
And then all of, you know, that his daughter ascends to take his role and she frees the north of the ruling.
Of the world, yeah, of the ruling.
So that's all, these are all great ideas, you know, that the Mad King comes full circle to Mad Queen.
Mm.
The King Slayer becomes the Queen Slayer. So
there's
interesting full circles going on here.
Yeah.
But these guys have just such a tutty job of doing it.
And that's the thing, right? To bring shocks to the people, to subvert and, you know, to be like, nahi, this is unexpected. You've just lost the story. And we, Red Wedding was unexpected. Yes, we all felt it, but it was... Like he said, you know, the Scepter of Baelor, when it was blowing up, it was written to something, it led to something that was a destructive but a good, satisfying conclusion to that season. And all these big shocks that they've had, they made sense. In hindsight, when you see it, you'll be like, oh my God, yeah, Littlefinger did tell Ned Stark, meko trust mat karo. And yeah, he did that and then he died. But just the last season has just been shocks without anything. So it's been very khokhla. To come to think of it. And that's,
you know,
just...
I would recommend if anybody's out there, like, you're completely disappointed, start reading the books.
I'm going to start reading the books again. I had read till book 2, but I'm going to start again because
the second book is the most boring one. The first one is interesting.
Yeah.
Third and fourth also.
The first one was a banger, dude. Very, very good. Very good book.
And they really stayed true to it.
Yeah. Exactly. They were loyal to the books till, I think, season four or something.
Yeah. I think at first I would say, hey, they rushed it. That's why it didn't work. They just didn't work.
Yeah. And, we've read enough. We know HBO wanted to give them the full season, but the two D's decided to wrap it up in 6 episodes. They didn't want to do more. So you can see, you know, and like I said, stupid errors like Starbucks cup and water bottles. Are you mad? You've had 2 years to make this.
That is not that, you know, it just
shows a lack of.
Yeah, this goes beyond that. This has left such a unsatisfactory.
Yeah.
See, I'm not saying that the show needs to be made to cater to fans. Mm. The idea of Game of Thrones is not to cater to fans, but to shock fans.
Exactly. But
and now they've gone full service, 7-meal course to catering.
Yeah.
Everybody needs to have a happy end.
Yeah.
Everybody had a had their just desserts. Let's put it that way. You know, and what? So I yeah, I'm not going to do another podcast on Game of Thrones for sure. Till the next one comes out.
Till the prequels come out.
I think as a world phenom, I think it's gone.
History will be kinder to Game of Thrones later.
No, I think D&D were like the heroes of LA as producers and writers.
Hmm.
But I think the...
They're going to tackle Star Wars next. And if Game of Thrones fandom tum logo ko lagta hai zyada hai, toh Star Wars toh tum logo ko maar dega. D&D toh
wo achcha karna padega. Rajiv Masand, if you're out there, good luck. Because he's a Star Wars fan. Like, you'll be pissed. I don't give a shit about Star Wars.
Okay.
No, but I just...
I like Star Wars.
Let's wrap this up with just a comment on like the other things that like... Hmm. Obviously, the DOP, the camera work...
Spectacular.
Was amazing. The green screen work in this show is exceptional.
Yep.
Even now with that one shot of Drogon blasting the Iron Throne and Jon Snow covered in that was the shot. The same way the last episode, the shot of the Clegane Bowl with the dragon flying.
Yes, yes. And beautiful, also beautiful to watch.
The pyrotechnics, just all of it was incredible. They literally took one street though. If you notice King's Landing, basically they've taken one street and shown again and again and again. And they show the same street again. Yeah. So you can tell that the little bit of budget constraint. But the people who worked on the sets, the set design, the costume design.
The costumes. My God, they've been bangered.
Yeah.
The costumes are insane in the show.
Even the weak actors, like I think the Sophie Turner is one of the weakest actors on the show. She's got the biggest role outside the show. She's playing in X-Men.
Dark Phoenix.
But trust me, that's not going to work. I
don't really watch. I mean,
have you watched anything that Kit Harington has done outside Jon Snow?
No, I haven't.
It does not work.
He's
does not
done
work.
A good job.
McQueen. You always be McQueen.
I want to watch. We're talking about actors doing work outside GOT. Nikolai Coster-Waldau, who plays Jamie. I'm obsessed with him. So I googled what he's doing.
That's a lady boner.
Shut up, don't say that. I googled what he's doing next, and he's doing this movie where like polar bears commit suicide and shit. It's a very weird movie. He's doing this Danish film, and he's got a weird career, and I'm into that. So
aise karte hain, we'll do a podcast. Let's do the show justice, not the show, the story justice.
Right.
When the book comes out, as soon as the book comes out,
the book comes out in our lifetime,
it will come out. It'll come out the next year or so.
Okay.
What I'll do is I will read the book and then right where the story left off.
Right.
I will do a recap of the story.
Oh, that's great.
So if you guys are not book readers, you know what I can do? Maybe is some sort of comparison to the show.
Yeah, like a TLDR. Yeah. You know, just to make your life easy. Also.
Just to give people satisfaction. That yar, hamara itna time gaya isme. Hum log itne saare dekh rahe hain. Oh my God. I think the last thing I want to say is I think the killing of Daenerys is a great sort of example of what the show has become. You know, like what they did was they killed her off screen. Like they stabbed her off screen. They didn't even show her getting stabbed.
No, I mean,
they show a little blood coming, right? And it was done in a way that I've seen Amir Khan do to heroines. I don't know, man. These are such a shitty way to show the death of a character that's gone from having being royalty to having nothing.
Yeah.
to being a nomad, to then suddenly being a leader in a small town, to then growing the army to a huge army, going to a different...
It's been a disservice, man, like, to a character.
This character's gone through this...
She's gone through the most in this show. She's had the most... It's and I get it, dude. You want to make a mad queen, then just be convincing about it. Don't make it just because, I don't know, I got very angry.
And the books do such a better job. Even like Jon Snow, who's such a bland actor, such a bland character. Oh, no, nothing on... He has like two lines basically, he keeps repeating.
My queen, she's my queen.
But in the books, because he has a perspective, you actually know. Like for example, you know, just reading book one, I say randomly.
Exactly. I remember this. When I had seen the first season of Game of Thrones, I was like, yeah, okay, Jon Snow is whatever. My friend found him really cute. I was like, okay, theek hai. Then I read the book and I was like, oh my god, this character is actually very, very good and so well written.
He wanted to go to the wall, for example, season one, right? And he, so he's very wide-eyed about it. It'll be honorable. At least I can do my own thing because the cattle stocks always on my ass. And he goes there and he's like, what have I done?
I have made a huge mistake.
I have made a huge mistake. Arrested Development.
Always.
Anyway.
Wo show aapko, nahin, even that show has been disappointing. The Netflix seasons.
Uska first three seasons.
Dekho.
Yeah, same. So yeah, I think sometimes, you know, they too much of a good thing.
Yeah.
You know, and I think that's what happens in American storytelling is that it becomes too much of a good thing. I think The Office season 8, 9 goes on. You know,
I think 30 Rock was a good example of a good start to finish. Seven seasons mein khatam ho gaya.
Seinfeld also. Khatam karo. Even but, like Friends, you know, the, towards last season, suddenly there was a Joey and Rachel.
Yeah, that was unrequired. So, I think
there's a need. There's a commercial need, and I think George R. R. Martin has been very vocal about that. They see, hey, this character, for example, Bronn. Bronn's a great example of a character that's just not relevant.
Yeah.
Just not in the books. Just and I know that George R. R. Martin has nothing really for that character. He's just a guy who's trying to make his way. But isme isko Lord of High Tower bana diya hai, you know, and
High Garden.
High Tower is the name of the cop in Police Academy. You guys have no idea, but it was a really funny movie.
Okay.
This is when I was a kid.
Okay.
Like Police Academy, there are like five of them.
Nice. I've heard of Police Academy.
Damn funny. Very funny series. Very, very Bollywood.
And then I'll watch it. But HBO has other shows also. Big Little Lies season 2 is coming. Thanda? It has Meryl Streep.
HBO's next show, just watch, is Watchmen. That is going to be the...
No. Big Little Lies season 2. Show recommendation.
If you have a penis and you're watching that show, I'm coming for you.
Why? It's a great show. Please watch it. You'll have so much better perspective on women in general. Iski mat suno. Hum sab bahut sad hai, guys. I think abhi hum lunch khayenge. Yeah.
Main to sone ja raha hun.
Okay.
After that, I'm in depression.
Okay. That's very sad.
If you somehow disagree with us and you like the episode, leave a comment and I will blast you why you I think you're wrong. But if you agree with what we have to say, then, you know, leave. You know, I think use the comment section to vent.
Yes, please do. Please write whatever you found, whatever you thought about the episode. Good, bad, ugly, anything. Just write your thoughts out. We really like to read. Because I think in the previous episodes, our episodes, we've been reading so many of y'all, you know, writing your theories down, thinking what is going to happen. And I think that's really cool.
If you guys have reached this point and you're still watching the podcast, let's write a question that you that's bothering you. And we'll try to answer it.
It's like we're a therapy, this thing.
Yeah, because so like, come for, to us. Like, I have lots of questions still. And I want to ask people, like, I want to ask D&D, like, why in the whole season did Dany treat Sansa as a peer?
Hmm.
In what way are they peers?
Yeah.
You have an army and a dragon.
She needs to be
bowing to you.
And she didn't.
She didn't. And so what is... I don't
understand. She's like a spoiled child in this one. Yeah.
No, but
yeah. Anyway. Tell us what you think.
So
and we'll try our best to answer them. We'll try our best to give you support.
If you go into depression after watching this, don't worry. We'll create a some sort of group. I'm just kidding. There's no group. Just find a therapist.
Find another show. Yeah, find a therapist, number one. Please find a therapist if you're depressed.
No,
yeah,
there's no other show. There's no other show like this.
There's no other show like this. That's why I'm going to miss it so much. That's why I love it so much, despite the last season. And when I do start my rewatch, I am going to try to see it with a different filter, different lens. I don't know. But I will. I'm going to start watching it again. Because I got to. This is my closure.
And now my watch All begins. My memories. Chalo. It's been fun. I'll see you guys... I don't know. She'll see. She'll be doing Chugli
again. I'll be doing Chugli. Please stay tuned. I was a little sick. That's why the last episode didn't come out. But I did a live instead. But Chugli will be out this week. Please dekhiye. Ye sab kya ho raha hai? Manushka show hai. Please dekhiye. And we'll be coming up with new things. Often. Yeah.
Adios.
Thanks. I love you all. Bye.